Mr. Speaker, it won't surprise anyone in this House that I'm vehemently opposed to this bill, the Employment Relations Amendment Bill number 2, from a government who made a commitment to the trade union, to the CTU, that they would not rush through legislation, they would listen, who by the Minister's own acknowledgement that access to workplaces is not a problem, that employers there was no need to change it. But again, true to its colours, this government had to go backwards in time. And when I talk about backwards in time, let's look at the 90s, just very quickly, Mr. Speaker. Who was in government then? It was the National Party. And what did they do? The first thing that they did when they were in government is they scrapped the pay equity legislation. The very first thing. And they've done exactly the same thing again. And then what else did they do? They passed the Employment Contracts Act. That really, that was then, in those days, was actually recognised as an attack and an assault on workers. And this government, never mind you chipping, the member chipping in, this government is doing exactly the same thing again. Exactly the same thing. And they scrapped the Apprenticeship Act. That was another way of not creating jobs. That is what that government did, and they are doing, and they had dear old Max Bradford wanting to buy the extra week's holiday. Surprise, surprise. Old David Bennett sitting there looking forward to chairing this bill when it's before the committee, and I will tell members in this House that it is an absolute insult to workers. And for the Minister to actually stand there and say, talk about fairness and balance, it is utterly and completely ridiculous. This bill is unfair, it is unbalanced, but most importantly of all, it is unnecessary. We heard Jackie Blue turning the figures around, saying because of this bill, 75% of the few people who managed to get a job in New Zealand managed to keep their job. But what it actually means, yes, I can see the Minister nodding over there. Would the member just repeat what she said?
No.
Okay. But what it actually means is that 25% of workers in New Zealand were dumped in the first 3 months. And that was just a select group of workplaces. But this government is now saying, oh gosh, we're not doing it tough enough. We will extend that to every workplace in New Zealand. It is absolutely shocking stuff. And we heard the Māori Party talking about there is no job creation under this government. It is actually stopping, it is actually preventing employment. And what can members, we know, and it's pretty rich when you look around this House or over the other side, that anyone can be sat in a job for the first 90 days for any reason whatsoever, and that reason doesn't have to be given. It might be that they don't like the clothes they wear. It might be that they don't like their haircut, mightn't it? You know, it might be. No reason needs to be given. And I would say to this House that if a young person's first experience of job, or experiment, because it is an experiment, first experience of work is to be sacked with no cause and no reason, how does that set them up for the future? And this is a government that is supposed to care. But the other thing that, again, in line with keeping the government that doesn't think about creating or keeping jobs or anything, in terms of reinstatement, if in a personal grievance a worker loses a job and it is deemed to be unfair, surely it is right that that worker should have the right to get that job back. Isn't that fair? If an employer has sacked a worker and they're lucky enough to have access to personal grievance proceedings because they've been there for more than 3 months, if it is deemed that that employer botched up, why, in the middle of a recession with no recovery happening, Would a government remove reinstatement as the primary remedy? Why would they do that? It is mean-spirited, mean-willed and mean-spirited from a mean government. This government, despite all the rhetoric about caring, and I think that's what we on this side of the House find so offensive. We care, so we're going to make it easier for you to be sacked. We care, so we are going to actually say that if you're sacked and it's unjustified, then reinstatement isn't a primary remedy. Now, I would like the Minister or someone in the National Party to take a call and explain to this House why, if a worker's been dismissed without cause and without justification, why that worker can't have their job back. And I'd urge someone in the party, perhaps would Toe Henry be able to take...
Well, he's very reasonable.
He is a reasonable person, and he's had experience of representing workers. Not in a very good way, I will accept, but experience nonetheless. So, Mr Speaker, this is a sad day. This is a sad day for workers in New Zealand. And the fact that this bill is going to get hurried through to be reported back in November, a nice Christmas present for workers in New Zealand. Here we go again. Let's just deal, and we know who will be the worst affected by this bill. Who will it be? We've seen examples of workplace bullying, and that's a point of the Roy, and we've all got a lot of sympathy in terms of that workplace bullying that we've seen today. And I know I can see Sir Roger nodding his head there and thinking it's not on, but Heather Roy has still got a job. What we are looking at is young workers, vulnerable workers, who are not going to have an opportunity. They're not going to have an opportunity to stay in their job, a job that they may have worked really, really hard to get. And this government is removing that right from them. Mr Speaker, I also want to draw attention, if we look at what we have seen in the short time that this government has been in power, we still have victims' rights legislation languishing on the order paper that would actually give real support to victims of domestic violence in New Zealand. But what does the Minister say? That will be introduced when they can afford it. When they can afford it, that will be introduced. Languishing on the order paper. And instead, this government is racing through legislation that once again is dealing to workers. And, you know, I'd have more respect for the government if they said, look, we launched this at the National Party conference because we knew our constituency like dealing to workers. They like it. That's part of what National's about. If they said that, we'd at least respect them for a degree of honesty. A degree of honesty. But what they do is they say, we're from the National Party and we're here to help workers. Well, I don't think anyone, certainly no one on this side of the House, believes that. And I know in their heart of hearts that National members don't believe that either. It's just like their welfare reforms. They're there to help people into work. And what do we say? Find the jobs. Invest in people. Invest in the economy. Create the jobs. Then people will work and people will be able to keep their jobs. Don't take away their right to get a job. As Ken Douglas said, when his granddad said to him, when you get a job, look after it because someone worked very hard. A dinosaur. That's rich coming from that member. That's a doozy coming from that member, calling people dinosaurs. That is a real doozy. Mr Speaker, this bill is an insult to workers in New Zealand. It is an insult to families in New Zealand, and it is something that should not happen. And I'm really pleased that that on this side of the House, that with the Green Party, the Maori Party, that we are vehemently opposed to this bill. And I'm telling you, there will be many submissions before the Select Committee telling this government what a lousy job they are doing in industrial relations and what a bad minister they have.